Hello everyone, my name is Ziafatullah Saeedi and I've come all the way from Kabul, Afghanistan to share my story with you at AMENDS. Actually, when I was looking back to prepare my talk, I watched a lot of videos of previous Afghan delegates to see what they've talked about. And the epitome of every single talk is one word, and that is education. So I think that pretty much tells you what is the primary concern in Afghanistan. But my parents were particularly concerned with education in Afghanistan. And that's partly because they themselves were deprived of education in their youth. My father could only experience what education means and what is school means for 3 years because of persisting discrimination against ethnic and religious minorities in Afghanistan. Tragically, the same thing almost happened to my mom, but that did not stop them to do their best to educate me. Right after the deposition of the Taliban, which is sadly the icon of Afghanistan, they enrolled me into a very local small school where I made a lot of friends. But our school was not about making friends only. At age 6, for the first time in my life, I experienced segregation in my school. There were like 400 school students in our school from two different ethnic groups, Sunni Pashtuns and Shia Hazaras. And there was a clear segregation between the two. In the class, Hazaras were sitting with Hazaras, Pashtuns were sitting with Pashtuns. We used to take yogurt as a snack to our school, but during the break, we used to refuse each other's snack because we thought there was a problem with Sunni's food and there was a problem with Shia's food. But back then, I used to think that it was very distinct to my life and it was very distinct to my region. But when I grew up, I understood that this was pretty common in all around Afghanistan. So this just gave me an inspiration to start the first summer camp in Afghanistan. It's called Rainbow Cultural Diversity Summer Program. It was the first summer program when we started. Few people knew what a summer camp is, actually. The mission behind Rainbow is to bring youths of different ethnic groups from different regions together. And through this way, we promote cultural diversity through making a multicultural space for them. We host a bunch of activities in our summer camp. All are particularly designed to expose members of one ethnic group to other ethnic groups and let them know, discover the commonalities between them. And that way, we make them more open and more responsible citizens to the country. The activities include a lot of things. The first one is discussion. We get the participants to discuss themselves what is ethnicity, and they try to challenge the concept of ethnicity and their own perception from each other. So, and the next one is panel discussion. We get the writers, civil activists, to discuss what is ethnicity, what is diversity, and how Afghanistan is stuck with that, and how we can reach a harmonious society. We also have cultural performances and ethnic dances, which is pretty amazing given the different ethnic groups in Afghanistan. And of course, occasionally we have proposals in our program. And that's me, by the way. And also, that's fake. Anyway, it was really hard to start this. It was not really easy to get members of different ethnic groups together. I remember when I started this in 2017, I went to the Sikh community, which is a very small minority in Afghanistan, and I asked them to send their children to our summer camp. They refused. I went to their shop, they refused. I went to their temple, they refused. I think that shows pretty much the high level of mistrust in Afghanistan, but things have been changing since we started Rainbow. Back then, people did not know what a summer camp meant in Afghanistan. When we were talking to school students, do you know what summer camp is? And for most of them, it did not ring any bell. But now we have 7 summer camps all across Afghanistan, and luckily everyone includes sessions on intercultural, interfaith harmony and interethnic harmony. We've also tremendously have contributed to the public discourse. Our work was featured by national and international journals, which shed a lot of light on the topic of cultural diversity and harmony in Afghanistan. We have also created a chain of rainbow where we, at the end of the summer program, we put all the network and the equipment at the disposal of our participants to recreate their own program and organize them in their own localities where we can't go because of insecurity. It has also been a journey for myself. I've learned that there is an unappreciated power in connection and interaction. We often don't see that one, but when we get people connected, we see that they're more tolerant. And of course, if they're isolated, if they're disconnected, the picture they have from each other is stereotypical. So we are facing a lot of a lot of violence, a lot of intolerance and sectarianism all over the Middle East. And I think that's what the message of Rainbow is to the entire Middle East. If we get the people connected, we can get rid of the stereotypes. We can create a clear understanding of each other. And let's do this. Thank you.